While the man I'm about to interview isn't in the military, he's an authority, and maybe he knows something about it. Hey, Rich, how you doing?
Good.
Hey, man, thanks for meeting with me tonight.
Yeah, no problem.
Yeah, appreciate it. So, as we discussed, you were in law enforcement and you had an encounter with a Bigfoot almost a decade ago, is that right?
More than that, two decades ago.
Wow.
July of 2000.
Can you tell me a little bit about that?
Yeah, I was coming down this road and I was on graveyard shift. Just the road happened to be clear at this moment when I'm coming down in my patrol car, and on the left side, this figure steps onto the roadway. I stopped my car and about 50 yards from it. I mean, the chest was massive, the thickness of it. It was covered in hair. 8 feet tall, around 800 to 1,000 pounds. And it was terrifying.
Did it stop in the road too? Or?
No, it didn't stop. It came out, profiled to me, never looked at me.
Did you see the face? Or?
No, it was profiled to me, so yeah. No face detail at all. It took 4 steps, hit the fence line on the other side of the road, and disappeared. That was it.
Were you running a dashboard camera or anything?
No. We didn't have stuff like that in those days.
What was your initial reaction?
And at first, it's shock and fear and frightened, you know. I didn't know what I was dealing with. So I know it's a Sasquatch, but there's more to it than meets the eye, even when you see it.
Do you think these things are dangerous, or...?
I could tell you that it changed my behavior dramatically.
How so?
Psychologically, it spooked me. I didn't like to go places alone for quite some time. It took me years before I was able to really start enjoying myself again like that. Something was being put into me and forcing me to feel a way that was abnormal and unnatural. This emptiness, like this black hole.
So you're feeling an unnormal dread?
Yeah, feeling a dread. If it wanted to do something to somebody, there's nothing anybody could do about it. It could just sneak up behind you and just grab you like that, and you'd be done.
Yeah. I've heard specific reports of people in high government or military positions having knowledge of Bigfoot. Do you know anything about that?
I don't know. I actually wrote a memo to the sheriff's office, categorized this as an unknown phenomenon. Yeah, it was all documented.
Do you think that that goes up further the chain of command, or?
I don't know whatever happened to that.
After you had that first encounter, you started researching more into the subject. What kind of things did you come across?
When I first came into this thing, I was looking at it as a law enforcement investigator. And then I was finding so much evidence, it was real apparent to me that there was a lot more of these things around.
What type of sort of topography or geographical markers should we be looking for?
Well, there's a lot of major drainages. They create natural pathways.
A drainage? You mean like a hollow where the water comes off the mountain?
It's easier walking, it has less grading. These things have been using them for thousands of years to get from point A to point B. In an area of Mason County, there was so much density of sightings, and it certainly wasn't the same Bigfoots popping up all over the county.
Yeah.
There seems to be, generally, I think, groups of 3 to 5.
So, Rich, when you say groupings, are you referring to, like, a family of Bigfoot?
Yeah, family groupings.
Yeah.
There seems to be groups going up most in every drainage area.
This is pretty significant.
Families of Bigfoot, moving in social groups like primates. This is tremendous. The theory of multiple Bigfoots traveling together lines up perfectly with the evidence we collected in Kentucky. Howls coming from multiple locations, and the witness who found what she believed to be a small print found within a larger print.
There was another footprint inside of that footprint.
Oh, wow.
Maybe there was something stepping in the side of the tracks.
Yeah.
If you ever notice deer, the fawns stay really close to mom.
Mm.
And I was like, could this be baby that are following their mother?
If the Bigfoot here move in family units, then the team needs to be on the lookout for a greater range of evidence. For example, juveniles have smaller footprints and are commonly mistaken for human. We'll have to be diligent out there.
I hear so often that people will witness these things crossing the road, just as you experienced.
Makes me think I need to pay special attention to the roadways in our target zone.
Maybe we could get lucky.
Possibly, yeah.
Yeah.
quiet and dark and very, very calm here. I'm about 1,000 feet above that water source.
This is our night. We have the element of surprise. Hopefully, we'll get some action.
Russell is on top of a ridgeline overlooking a small river that he believes is a prime target to spot Bigfoot.
Right now, I'm just looking for anything that puts off a heat trace. And when I see something that has a red signature, it means it is holding heat. And one of the prime examples of that is I'm on this hillside. You can tell that there's rocks on that hillside over there because the rocks have held the heat through the daytime. The only other thing that's going to show that kind of color would be a hot-blooded animal. There's something down there. I see something down on the far side of the valley that's very interesting. There it is. It's moving. I need to put this thing on the tripod so I can stabilize it. I'm going to zoom in on that a little bit. It's not moving anymore.
I really want you to see this. Right here, it's an upright red.
Do you see that? I'm going to bring it in tighter.
Do you see that?
That does look like something's standing there.
It looks like someone's just standing there. Holy. I need to go to that same point in person and see if there's any secondary evidence to tell me, was it a deer? Was it an elk? Was it a bear? Or did we see Bigfoot? So we'll look in that clearing over there tomorrow.
Hey, Russell, what's going on, man?
Hey, Bryce.
I got something on the thermals last night that I need to show you.
I just sent it, so you should get it any second now.
This thing, I thought it was actually
heat coming off the rocks. And I just came over here and confirmed there's no rocks over here.
Whatever it was, it put out a really hot trace. It was human-like in structure and put out a tremendous amount of heat.
Yeah. Let me pull it up here. Hold on. Oh, what the hell is that?
That thing just stood there, stock still for the longest time.
It was like it was looking down over the valley, maybe hunting deer or something.
But it did not move. It was
just the strangest thing, the way it just stood there.
Let me just take a look at where you are.
There's a berry patch about
a mile and a half down from where you are. I think you should descend down there and check it out. It's huge. It's definitely a point of interest.
Absolutely.
Will do. Summer right now, berries are blooming everywhere. And what I'm really on the lookout for are the huckleberries. A lot of testimonies from people say that huckleberries are their favorite. Native American legends state the same thing. So if we see huckleberries in large concentrations, we know we're on the right track.
Look at this. Something has actually brushed up against this. Right here and here and here. That is interesting, though. You know how an animal will get against it? You know all the different strands of hair? This looks like something a little bit more solid than that.
It's not a finding that we can say definitively what it was.
It didn't look like fur. Fur would leave the sweeping motion like a paintbrush would. This actually looked like skin contact or something more solid than that.
Oh, look here, the other half of it sits. If you look down this road, this is an old, old logging road. It hasn't been used. There's trees growing up into it. But there's no tracks, no nothing. This thing has been sitting here for quite some time. It seems like a lot of the stories you hear around Bigfoot, a lot of the natives would say that Bigfoot is the protector of the forest, the protector of nature. And this isn't how this is supposed to look. This is how it's supposed to look.
If someone dropped this in my front yard, I wouldn't be too happy about it either. There's a game trail that runs off here to the right. Looks like a pretty well-used game trail. I'm gonna go head out this way. Gonna keep marching forward. I've still got a few hours before I get there. I'm gonna head down to that wooded area to see if I can find any evidence of what was moving down there. What I saw was standing upright. So whether it was a human or a Bigfoot, I'm gonna find that evidence. But it's gonna be a long walk.